ages, and yeah, I'm gonna be doing part two of my general play. I slept off for a month. It's like I was gonna do a full series and all that stuff, but life got ahead of me on that one. So I'm now gonna try attempt to do it, and I'm gonna try to do it more regularly. I've also now partnered with one of my friends, my real life friends, and he's also going to be contributing to the channel as well. So yeah, if you see White Wolf posting a lot of videos, that's not me, it's one of my friends. But yeah, we have partnered up to do YouTube together. So yeah, today I'm doing some WvW World. It's quite early in the morning, so I doubt that there will be too much fighting. I just honestly, I couldn't sleep this morning, so I decided to join the morning crew. Yeah, it's currently at 6:10 my time, AM. Smash it. Boom. Someone will cast speed on me. Ah, so they reinforce the gate, as you can see now. Can't be damaged. No damage. So yeah, just gotta wait for 30 seconds. Some players running around. No, that wasn't placed properly. Yeah, I just joined a group of random people that are playing this early in the morning. So, yeah, don't know any of them. Yeah, and instead of just doing some general PvE content, I'm doing WvW World because I need to still get a lot of skirmish tickets. Because I still haven't finished getting all my Wolvis World Legendary armor. And yeah, I'd very much like to get that done. And take it from there. I did do a Guild Wars efficiency check to give me like a plus minus time frame. And according to Guild Wars efficiency, if I had to get the max reward chest every week, it'll take me about 16 weeks to finish it. So pretty much a long time. 4 months to get the full set. You can do this also with PvP, and you can also do it with PvE as well. But right now, I'm just doing the PvP set because it's not PvP, World vs World, because it's what I enjoy. But yeah, I would think it'll take me about 20 weeks if I'm being realistic with myself. For the very reason I'm not always able to get max chests every week. And the chests I'm referring to, oopsie, are these. It'll take about 14 and a half hours, I believe, they say. Yeah, if you get max participation and everything, it'll take you plus minus 14 and a half hours per week. Just to get those chests, these chests. But yeah, at the moment, I can't always guarantee that I'll be able to play for 14 hours in a week. Work is just so busy. But yeah, you get a max of 365 skirmish tickets a week. And each piece of gear, if you don't have the gear ready, costs 1,100, I believe it was, 1,200 skirmish tickets. These things here at the bottom. It's not impossible, but yeah, it's not always easy to do it. Because unfortunately, real life likes to take a turn and distract you from doing what you want to do. Okay, so it looks like we're going for enemy garrison. But I will be honest, I managed to get my conflux, my legendary ring. If you check, there's like a little floating ball next to mine. That'll just move away from the group. There, the floating ball. Yay! Yeah, that is conflux. It's a cool little legendary ring. But just for the record, getting legendaries is not really that important. If you just get ascendant gear, your pink gear, it's pretty much the same stats. The only advantage to legendary gear versus ascendant gear is the fact that you can change the stats straight away, and you can just literally just swap them out onto any character. And that is purely the only benefit to getting purple gear versus pink gear. And purple gear has a shiny to it. So if you want to be looking all nice and spiffy and shiny, then you get your legendary gear. If not, then you're cool with just having normal gear that's pink, just as good. Though I really wouldn't mind that nice flaming back that this guy has. As you can see, like, even my hands, I've got flaming gloves, so like, wow. Come on, knock the door down. Eesh, my tea's finished. I would like some tea. Okay, there's someone on top there. And they're hitting me. But yeah, just to clarify, I'm gonna say it's gonna take me 14 weeks, blah blah blah, to get my full set. It's a little bit of a grind, but it's not so much a grind. By the time you get there, you'll have everything you need to craft the items. And like I said, I'm doing content which I enjoy. So 14 weeks, I mean, 16 weeks sounds like a long time. 4 months. But it's only because I'm time gated to the amount of skirmish tickets I can get. And yeah, when I wasn't so busy, I could get all my skirmish tickets done by Sunday and the resets on Friday and still play World vs. World and enjoy myself. But for the time being, just my time is limited. There's a player down there, just behind that archer. Now currently we're destroying the oil, because the oil can do quite a bit of damage towards the siege equipment. Okay, now you see our commander will place some siege down. I think. Now where'd our commander go? Yep, there goes commander. Always allow the commander to place the siege, because he gauges like how the group is going to progress. That's at 48%. 46, 44. And there's a guy shooting the gates of the catapults as well. Oh, NPC. The guy back there, you can see the catapult name at the back, behind the door. They do that to push the people that are on the gates backwards. But the way our commander placed these siege equipment was actually quite good. So it nullifies that ability. Gates is down and we're all rushing. Wah! Charge! Destroying the cadres. There's the player. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, now we just move on to Lord. And it's just a matter of DPSing the Lord down. Boom, boom, boom. Extra abandoned. Have some speed, everybody. Burn, baby, burn. Yeah, it's just a matter of bringing it down as fast as possible. But it scales up to the amount of players that are attacking it. So in our case it's 33 players. So he's been scaled up to times 33. I don't know the exact number. Woohoo. And the garrison is now ours. And the little orange dot you see on the map is the player panicking, he doesn't know where to go. He's probably going to bail out unless he's a mesmer. Then he will try and hide somewhere. Because what they do is they will hide a player. And then he'll be able to port his friends back in. So yeah, now we just play catch up to the commander. Hopefully they'll take us to get more supplies. Why is it gonna take us straight to the other base? Okay, I'll just go switch my alarm real quickly. It's like, now's the time I wake up. Let me just get to that tag and then I will switch my alarm off. bounce, bounce, bounce. Oh shit, gas already open. Oh. Only our commander got in. Oop. So our enemy flipped it before we could get there. Be right back, let's switch my alarm off. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, so we've got the catapults down there. Boom, boom. One's attacking this wall here. And then the other is attacking the one inside. And there's no point in rushing the commander right now because we still got, I think, 2 minutes. Yeah, 2.5 minutes. So this wall's about to crumble. Watch this, watch this. Oh, smashed. And there goes the little replay running away. Good luck to him, buddy. Pardon me. I don't know where that joint came from, but it slipped out. Come on. Yeah, that guy from AGC is just trailing us right now. He's trying to pull us out of the wall. Okay, we still can't do anything for another minute. And I'm actually going to stop the video once we claim it. I want to start getting ready for work and stuff. Yeah, like I said, real life really kicks in here, man. Top of 6 in the morning and then I have to go to work. Well, I actually have to leave here by 7, but yeah. And it's a Saturday, man. Working on a Saturday. I will be doing more work tomorrow, which will be the Sunday, but yeah. It gets quite taxing after a while. But we all need to make the work. What do we? So we all need to make the monies. Gotta pay them bills, gotta make them food. Nice yummy food. Okay. Now we run down here. Ding ding ding, we're getting it. Woo! Yeah. Ah. Okay guys, I just want to say thank you for watching. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. So this is Aegis signing out.